There are literally dozens of young men who can come up today and speak and share deep in his service with you. We are actually having just two representations, one Talmud in the Yeshiva Gedola, one of our Masifta Bachrim. And at this time, I would like to call up Nassim Geller from the Yeshiva Gedola to please come address the Tzibur.
Such a special crowd. I know Ravam, I know some of your children, and they're all amazing people. So you'd all have to imagine that they have amazing parents and fathers. Hanukkah is approaching. It's coming the next week and a half. And usually before Yom Tov, a person has to ask themselves, you know, Yom Tov's coming. What is it? You know, what happened? Why did we celebrate this Yom Tov? So what happened on Hanukkah? The Yevanim came, they entered to our city, and you know, it wasn't a war, they just came in. And after a while, they started to say, you know what, these customs that they have, they think they're better than us, they try to separate from us. You know what, let's stop this. So what they do, they start banning some of the mitzvahs that we have. Which mitzvahs did they ban? They ban three very epitomizing mitzvahs that we have that makes us who we are. They ban Shabbos, they ban Milah, and they ban Chodesh, Rosh Chodesh. To my understanding, these mitzvahs they ban because they are mitzvahs that we can see and we reflect on very deeply because it happens most often. Shabbos happens once a week. Milah is something that, you know, it's a visual thing that we have every day, and it's something that separates us from everybody else. And Chodesh happens once a month. So what were their hopes? Why did they ban these three? What was their intention? Their intention was to show us that, you know, give up these, the less they remind themselves of who they are and what religion they have and who their God is, the more they'll start to realize that there's not that many difference between us and them. We're really the same, you know. We look the same, we have the same, you know, hair, whatever it is, the same looks. So after, you know, Hashem made a miracle and we were able to drive them out of Yerushalayim, and we were able to send them away, we still had the impression that they left on us. They broke our walls. They literally broke our walls more than physically, spiritually. And we were left to rebuild that wall. Now how do you build a wall? What do you use to build a wall? You need stones. Evan. Last week's parshas by Yetze, we see a lot about Evan. Evan with Yaakov when he slept in Har Moriah, surrounded himself with 12 stones. 12, maybe, you know. Shvatim, I don't know. And he made it into a tent of Hashem, a Har Moriah. After he met, right before he met Rachel, talks about a stone that was on the well. And he picked it up just by himself. Later, at the end of the parasha, after Yaakov left with his wives and his children, and Laban found out and chased him, so Hashem approached Laban. While he's chasing, he says, be careful what you say to Yaakov, be careful what you do, don't hurt him. So Laban and Yaakov sat down, they spoke. They said, I can't touch you, Hashem told me not to touch you. So he said, you know what, let's make a shvuah. What they do, they took a bunch of stones, they piled them up, and he said, this stone will stand between me and you. This will be our testament between each other. That if you break this bond, if you break and you come over to my side, this mound of stones and Hashem will be the witness. So what's the deal with the Adam? I don't understand what's the deal with stones. There's a custom that when people who are from other religions. They go to a cemetery, they bring flowers, they leave flowers on the matzeva. When Jews go, they leave rocks. I don't understand, why do they leave rocks? So flowers, you have to keep bringing flowers, flowers die. Rocks last forever. Every rock that we have till today is from the beginning of time, the real ones. I mean, you can, I guess, make a big rock, but the real ones, they last forever. They're from the beginning of time. They'll be here. They were here way before we were here, and they'll be here way longer than after we were. So what does that mean? So I heard Hashem, my Rebbe, who said it, Hashem's father, the Evan is Av and Ben. Av and Ben. Because the values that a father instills in his children, his sons, are the values that the son grows up with, that he keeps, and then he gives over to his children. It's all Messiah. We are who we are today because of our parents, and because of our grandparents, and because of our great-grandparents, because of the Avos. They're called Avos for a reason. Because the impression that they had on us, everything that we have, is because of them. Okay, so now we know. Now we know what Evan is. Evan is Av and Ben. Evan is something that lasts forever. So now how do you get one stone to stick with another? You know, you have to stick them together. It's not so simple. So, it says in the Rambam, Perash Al Mishnayos, it says that a Talmud Chacham is called Chavar. Why is Talmud Chacham called Chavar? Because through Limud HaTorah, through learning, a person, a Talmud Chacham, becomes mechaber with the rest of the world, with everybody else. Through his learning. And Meretz Hashem, you know, through this learning, that the Rebbeim and the fathers tried to instill in his children, will be able to rebuild the wall, both physically and spiritually, for everything that's going on. We need this wall, you know, in the crazy things that are going on today, and here, and in Eretz Yisrael. And Meretz Hashem, we'll be able to rebuild that wall, and we'll see the Gula, and Mashiach will come soon.
Thank you so much. At this time, we're going to be